Very good morning. Once again, I welcome you all for this part of this sequential circuit design. That is, today we are going to discussing about the triggering. I start with the triggering and continues with the flip-flops. Since in the earlier part of this series, we have discussed about the SR flip-flop and CSR flip-flop. Now we are entering into the remaining flip-flop. Okay, now triggering. It is another one important terminology in the sequential circuit, or it is very important terminology in a sequential circuit. Why? Because it gives a trigger pulse to the subsequent states or subsequent stages or subsequent stages. So it gives the triggering pulses or trigger or enable signal to the subsequent states. So it is very important in a sequential circuit. The classification of this triggering is two. One is level triggering, another one is edge triggering. So again, the subdivisions of level triggering and edge triggerings are positive and negative. That means in which method the triggering is applied, in which method the triggering is applied to the circuit. I already explained in one part of the video, the triggering may be either in 0 to 1 or 1 to 0 transition period, either 0 to 1 or 1 to 0 transition period. So if you consider this as a pulse, here the transition period from 1 to 0, if you are going to apply a trigger pulse, means it is one category. Another one category, at the time of a transition between 0 to 1, between 0 to 1, that means the states 0 to 1, if you are going to apply the triggering pulse, means it is another one. If we consider this as a positive edge triggering or positive level triggering or positive triggering, means its opposite is a negative triggering. That's all. The meaning is what for positive and negative. Okay. Then what is mean by level and edge triggering? Level means this is the level. That means a state, either zero level or one level, or zero state or one state. This is a level. But one more thing, edge, that means at the time of a transition period, that is at the time of a transition period, that means here, we called this particular part or this particular part. Please listen carefully. So these two things are called in edges. This is called edges. What is mean by edge means this is the edge. So this is edge triggering. So at the time of transition between high to low or low to high, if a trigger pulse is given or a pulse is given or the device is getting the enable signal, that is called edge triggering. Then what is the level triggering? So this is one level, either zero level or a one level. This means this is zero level. Sorry, one level, this is zero level, high state or low state. So this is called level triggering. If you apply the trigger pulse at this particular duration, that means in the levels. So we called this as a level triggering. Okay. Then the screen gives unclear information about the level triggering. As I already mentioned in the earlier part or earlier slide, level triggering means the triggering pulse is applied either in a one state or zero state, or a zero level, one level, or high level or low level. That's all. So my device will be getting the enable signal or enabled at my enable input is high or low. High or low. That means here. That means here. It is giving a clear information to you. Okay, sometimes in your end semester examination, a two mark questions may be possible. So please be clear about this concept. And then what is meant by edge triggering? As already mentioned or explained to you here, the same thing, but at the time of changeover from one state to other state or one level to other level, that means here, zero to one transition. So the edge at the transition period, if you are applying a signal or a device will be gets enabled signal, means that is called edge triggering. Similarly here also the same thing. Okay, that means a high to low transition. So my change of output in the subsequent devices is only at the time of getting either positive or negative edge triggering pulses. If it is positive, means this is the negative edge triggering pulses. That means 0 to 1, rising from 0 to 1, 0 level to 1 is called the positive edge triggering. 1 to 0 transition is negative edge triggering. Definitely a possibility of asking a 2 more question in this particular topic. Now I am entering into the flip-flop. Another important topic in sequential circuit, so which is almost similar to, or we may call this as a latch. In earlier part we have discussed the latch, similarly here also same thing, but the name is in a flip-flop. We will see one by one. Flip-flop is also called as a latch. It is a single bit storage device. A similar explanation whatever we have discussed in the earlier part, the same thing. So it is a single bit storage device, which is store the device as the data only a temporary basis. That means at the time of next signal or a subsequent signal reaches, automatically it has to be changed. Okay, where it can be applicable or used? It is used in all the sequential circuits, either synchronous or asynchronous, whatever may be. Anyhow, in general sequential circuits, then similar to the latches, it is also having input and output signal. That means it has two inputs and two outputs, enabled signal, etc. We will see everything. So the flip-flops are mainly used in a sequential circuits, that is synchronous and asynchronous sequential circuits. So similar to the latch, it has two inputs. So one is the normal input, it has two outputs. One is normal output, another one is complementary output. That means Q and Q bar. One is Q means, another one is Q bar. Sometimes it may be called this as a Q and Qn plus 1. That's all. Then it has two inputs according to the flip-flops, or at least one input. Sometimes some flip-flops are having only one input. The logics, for the logic, zero is what? For logic, one is what? So for logic, 1 plus 5 volts is represented. For logic, 0, 0 volts can be represented. It can store the data until the next clock pulse is given. As already told, it is also a temporary storage device. So how long it stores the data? Till the next clock pulse is reached or given to the flip-flop. Okay, maybe a important question in your competitive examination. Then what are the types of flip-flops? It is another one important question in your end semester examinations, maybe a part A questions. So already we have discussed one SR flip-flop, set reset flip-flop, then clocked set reset flip-flop also we have discussed in the earlier part, then JK flip-flop, and then D flip-flop, and then T flip-flops. These are all the classifications. So the examination, maybe a question is write down the classifications of a flip-flop, or what are all the flip-flops available in sequential circuits. Answer is these four flip-flops are the major flip-flop classifications. Then another one important question may be in your in semester examination, that means applications of a flip-flop, where it can be applicable or adapted. It can be used in a counters, or it can be used for designing a counters. What is meant by counters? It counts some sequences. Counter is a unit or a device which counts certain sequences. Continuously occurring sequences can be countered. So that is called counter. Then frequency divider. Also having this flip-flop. And then it can be used in shift registers and also used as a storage registers. We can store the data. That means bits. store the bits. And shift registers means we can shift the data from one position to other positions, one place to other place in data communications also. That means communication applications in digital format means by using this registers, shift registers. And it's a sub-classifications also. There we will see such a things is in that corresponding part. That means in the forthcoming session. Okay, these are all the major applications of flip-flop. Can be used in a counter or can be used to design a counter and a frequency divider, shift registers and storage devices. And then now I'm entering into the first flip-flop. First flip-flop is called set reset flip-flop, SR flip-flop. So based upon the introduction part, you can get a clear idea about this. It has two inputs. One is set, another one is reset. This is called clock pulse. As already we have discussed in the first two slides, that is trigger pulses may be given to the flip-flops to operate or to change the states. Okay, that is clock pulse. It may be a level triggering or a edge triggering. Okay, then similar to input, it also has two outputs. One is a normal output, another one is a complemented output. That means a Q, Q bar, and sometimes it may be Q and Q n plus 1. Q and Q n plus 1. So the circuit diagram of a SR flip-flop. Here I am going to explaining the SR, set reset flip-flop, with positive edge triggering. Positive edge triggering. That means positive edge triggering in the sense whenever my trigger pulse is changing from 0 to 1, that is called positive edge triggering. At that duration only, it changes the output. So similar to the earlier part discussion, the SR flip-flop diagram is also same. It has four NAND gates. The two NAND gates are used for getting the inputs. Another two NAND gates are used here for receiving or getting the outputs. The output side NAND gates are connected in cross connections. That is anti-parallel connection. It means that output of first flip-flop first NAND gate is connected to one of the input of a second NAND gate, and second gate's output is connected to the one of the input of first gate. That means Q is connected to the input of a second, Q bar is connected to the input of a first NAND gate. Then clock pulses are given according to the changes or at the time of changing 0 to 1 transition period only, it changes the states. It changes its states. So we will see one by one the operation of SR flip-flop. That means here the truth table of SR flip-flop is given. Here the truth table for the SR flip-flop is given. My clock pulse is positive edge triggering. That means here the positive edge triggering is mentioning like this. That means 0 to 1 transition. 0 to 1 transition. If suppose negative edge triggering means 1 to 0 transition. It has to be mentioned either like that or like this. Since it is a positive edge triggering, the clock pulses are in up arrow 0 to 1. Then so remaining operations are similar to the previous discussion. That means SR flip-flops. That means whenever I'm taking my set and reset inputs are 0, 0 or 0, 1 or 1, 0 or 1, 1 combination. What will happen? That's all. So whenever my inputs are 0, 0, what is the output? No changes. That means whatever the assumptions we made in the previous state, that is Qn and Qn plus 1, the same state will be retained in the output. Then the second state or a second stage. So whenever my set and reset inputs are 0, 1 means it reset the values. That means the output will be resetted to 0, 0. This is another one part. And then third one, my input is 1, 0. My SR input is 1, 0. S equal to 1, R equal to 0. It set the values in the output as 1, 1. Then my clock pulses is in positive edge triggering enabled, but the inputs are 1, 1. My S and R inputs are 1, 1 means there is no changes or exactly we cannot determine forbidden level or indetermined level. This and all already we have discussed the same thing only here, the same operation also here. Let us see at least two operations here, either no change and reset or no change and set. See the previous diagram. That means here, take this. So whenever my input signal is transition of 0 to 1, that means 0 to 1. Since it is a positive, it's triggering. Positive, it's triggering. Each and every time the clock pulse is changing from 0 to 1 only, it changes the output or it has the enable pin. That means 1. So 1, 1. My S input equal to 0. Just I'm recollecting the information again. R input is also 0. So according to the truth table of NAND gate, one of the input is equal to 0 means my output will be 1. My output will be 1. Both inputs are now 1. Initially, here only please see or listen. So initially, I made the assumption my Q output equal to 1. Hence, the Q bar output equal to, Q equal to 0, my Q bar equal to 1. So what will happen? Since it is connected to here, the one of the input is now 0. So that makes the output of this gate is equal to 1. That comes to here. Both inputs are all the inputs of NAND gate equal to 1. Hence the output equal to 0. So whatever the assumption I made, the same assumption I retained here. No change. So no change the assumption. Then second case. Instead of 0, 1, I initially assumed that my Q is equal to 1. Q equal to 1. Hence Q bar equal to now 0. What will happen? Since the Q bar equal to 0, that 0 comes to here. That makes one of the input of this AND gate equal to 0. Hence the output is now changes to 1. 0 to 1. Okay. This one comes to here. This one comes to here now. What will happen? All the inputs of this gate is equal to 1, hence output equal to 0. Again, you see the two cases. First case, I initially assumed my Q output is equal to 0 in the previous operation. I retained the same thing or I obtained the same thing. If suppose I'm taking my Q output in the earlier state is 1 means the same thing only in the output, after tracing the output. Hence, whenever the clock input is high, that means positive, its triggering is high, and that means here high, S and R inputs are 0, 0. Even the Q output is equal to 0 or 1, it does not change its output. It does not change anything in the output. So the output will be no changing. The output will be no changing. Similarly, I'm going to explaining one more thing. That means here 1 and 1. Since at the time of positive it's triggering, automatically the clock pulse is equal to 1. Now I'm going to taking my S is equal to 0, R equal to 1. What will happen? What will happen? That means according to this truth table, 0, 1 means it reset the value. Whatever may be the output or assumption you made initially, that has to be resetted here. That has to be resetted here. Okay. So according to that, so initially S equal to 0, R equal to 1. Since one of the input is equal to 0, my S bar output equal to 1 here, all the inputs are 1, output will be 0. All the outputs are 1, inputs are 1, output will be 0. Now, initially I made my Q equal to 0. Hence Q bar equal to 1. Okay. One of the input is equal to 0 for this gate, that makes the output equal to 1. That 1 comes to here. All the inputs of this gate is equal to 1, hence output equal to 0. So my output now 0, 1. This is the first case. Initially, I take 0 as the previous state output. That means here. Then after tracing the applications or after applying the clock pulses, the output is also same. Now, I'm going to assume the previous state is what? 1 as a Q output and 0 as a Q bar output. What will happen? Since here 1, 0, what will happen? The Q bar equal to 0 means that comes to here. So one of the input of first gate is equal to now 0 and 1. This 1 returns here. So one of the input equal to 0 means what will happen? My output is equal to 0. So now initially I made the assumption equal to 0, 1, that changes to 0 now. Since it is 0 which is connected to here, all the inputs of this NAND gate equal to 0, so the output will be changing to 1. Okay, please listen here. So initially I made the assumption 0, 1, that is retained here, or that's reset the value as 0, 1. 1, 0, it also reset the value equal to 0, 1. 1, 0, that also reset the values equal to 0, 1. Similarly, you can explain all other possible combinations of input and output. That's all. So the same thing only given here. The same thing only given here for negative edge triggering. For negative edge triggering, you know what is the difference between positive and a negative edge triggering? So the negative edge triggering in the sense whenever the signal is changing from 1 to 0, 1 to 0. In the earlier part, the discussion is at the time of changing or transition of 0 to 1 is called positive edge triggering. Here everything is in a negative triggering. That means 1 to 0 transition. That means here. Down arrow. Same thing, same output will be possible. But the output will be changes in each and every flux only at the time of appearing the negative edge triggering in the clock input. That's all. Then K map for a SR flip flop. So I'm going to derive the expression for Qn plus 1. That means this one. You take this column. By assuming these two as a input combinations, so what you will be getting like this. By grouping this, and you can get the output is equal to S plus Q R bar. S plus Q R bar. That means what? At the time of grouping these four, it will give us one single variable. So this is only another one possible combination. Since two variables are grouping in three variable Karnaugh map, what will be the results? It gives Q R dash. Okay, that's all. So it is a SR flip-flop reduction. So by taking this, you can get the output. That means Qn plus 1 you are going to obtaining. For that, three inputs are taken. These are all the three inputs. These three, S, R, and Qn is taken. S, R, and Qn is taken. Then, as usual procedure of a Karnaugh map, you can draw the Karnaugh map, reduce it. Finally, you can obtain the equation. Then, based on the operations, we are going to derive or draw the two important tables. Please listen, it is very important at the time of designing of a sequential circuit in the forthcoming part of this unit. One is called application table or a characteristics table. Application table or a characteristics table. It is similar to or whatever the response we obtained and tabulated in the operation. That means in the earlier slide. That means in the same thing. Whatever be the output response you obtained during the operation, the same thing only here. Okay, the same thing only here. So this is called application table. Then excitation table I will explain now. So here 0, 0 to 1, 1. From this only this excitation table will be derived. That means here. That means this part only we are going to considering Qn and Qn plus 1 is taken, then what is the SR input? At the time of designing of any sequential circuit, either synchronous sequential circuit or asynchronous sequential circuit, you should know the excitation table of a flip-flops. All the flip-flops excitation tables are used to design a sequential circuit or used in a design of a sequential circuit. Either it may be in a counter or a shift register or whatever may be the circuit. Okay. So whenever my Qn and Qn plus 1, that means, please listen, 0, 0 and 0, 0. That's all. I'm considering these two things as these two states only mentioned here. 0, 0 means 0. 0, 0 means 0, 1, which is given here. Okay. Similarly, all other things is drawn here. So what is the input states at the time of executing our operation? That is called execution table. Execution table. By using this only, we are going to design a circuits. Then next flip-flop. Now I am switching over to the next flip-flop. It's called D flip-flop. It's called D flip-flop. Also called as delay flip-flops. Maybe one of the important question in your competitive examination or two more questions in your end semester examination. This is called delay flip-flop. D flip-flop or delay flip-flop. So how we can get, we will discuss later. In earlier flip-flop, it has two inputs, but here it is having only one input, that means D input. D means delay input. So it has only one input and one clock pulse and two outputs. Similar to all other flip-flops, this flip-flop is also has two outputs. Why we go for this? This is the next question. Or what is the advantages of this particular flip-flop, D flip-flop or delay flip-flop? Delay means a propagation delay. So this and all you might have studied in your fundamentals of other electronic devices. So why we go for this? The answer is to eliminate the indeterminate state of SR flip-flop. Where it is possible, that means at the time of discussing the earlier flip-flop, that is called a set-reset flip-flop. Set-reset flip-flop, my state, we considering S equal to 1, R equal to 1, what will be the output in that tabulation? That is called indeterminate or forbidden state. So whenever my set and reset inputs are 1, 1, it produces the indeterminate state. So to avoid this, we are moving to this flip-flop, delay flip-flop. Then sometimes a question may be like this. How we can get D flip-flop from the SR flip-flop? Very simple. We will see the same thing in the next slide. That means the same diagram we consider here. That means SR flip-flop. Please listen carefully. Another one important concept I'm going to explaining. That means SR flip-flop only I'm considering here. In the earlier part or in the earlier case, there is no this kind of a connection. That means this inverter is not there. Instead of that, straight away it is connected like this. This input is called S. This input is called R. Clock pulse is given. Hence, we called this as a SR flip-flop. So the title itself, you please see the title here. D flip-flop using SR flip-flop. So in your competitive examination or any university examination, the question may be like this. How we can convert a D flip-flop from a given SR flip-flop? The answer is just by connecting my S and R input by using one inverter or short the SR terminals using inverter. That means here I'm shorting. Here I'm shorting these two terminals. This point and this point is shorted by using a inverter. That's all. So this is called D flip-flop by using SR flip-flops. Here also we are considering the positive edge triggering. Positive edge triggering in the sense 0 to 1 transition. Then as already we have discussed, it has only one input. Therefore, the possible combinations of input may be either 0 or 1. Then what will be the output? That is the operation you should write in your examination. We will see the operation of this. That means positive edge triggering means what? 0 to 1 transition. So I always assume or having the assumption my clock input is equal to 1, 1. Please listen, very simple operation. Then now I consider my D input equal to 0. What will happen? Here it is 0. Since the inverter is connected here, the input is 0, 1. So it comes to 1 here. So all the inputs are 1 here. So my output will be 0. Here one of the input is 0. So my output will be 1. Here one of the input of this gate is equal to 0. My output equal to 1. Okay. Whatever may be the thing, you please listen. Initially, I made the assumption, maybe Q output equal to 0, Q bar equal to 1. Okay, whatever may be the things, the first assumption is Q equal to 0, Q bar equal to 1. So already my input equal to 0, based upon this state's conversion, clock pulse is a positive triggering, input, one of the input equal to 0, here one of the input equal to 1, since inverter inverts 0 into 1. So that makes the output of this AND gate is equal to 0, here 1. Okay. Since one of the input equal to 0 here, this makes the output equal to 1, Q bar. It is connected to here, hence output equal to 0. So listen here, the output equal to what? Very important thing. Okay. So here input is equal to 0, output equal to 0. Now, instead of this, I'm going to considering my input equal to 1. Please listen carefully. This 1 comes to here, one of the input now 1. Since here 1, my inverter output is equal to 0, that 0 comes to here, that 0 comes to here. Now, one of the input of this AND gate is equal to what? 0. So that makes the changes of 0 into 1 here, here 1, and here also 1. All the inputs are 1, so my output will be 0. Since one of the input equal to 0, what will happen? That makes the output is equal to 1. That makes the output equal to 1. Since it is 1, this is connected to here. So 1, 1, all the inputs are 1, my output will be 0. My output will be 0. Okay, that's all the output. See, listen carefully. Here one more concept I'm going to explaining to you. What is that? See these inputs. This is the input. This is the input I'm taking. What outputs I obtained here? This is the output. This is the output I obtained. I'm giving the input is 0. What is the output? 0. So if I'm taking my input as 0, output as 0. Okay. Or if I'm taking my input as 1, output is also 1. My Q output is also 1. But what is the difference? In D flip-flop, please keep it in your mind. Whatever may be the input, same thing only in the output. My D input is what? Same thing only in the Q output. But it has some delay, propagation delay. So only we called this a D flip-flop. So in your truth table, or it is a shortcut to remember, what is the D input? The same thing only in the output. So 0 means 0. So my D input equal to 0 means output is equal to 0. D input equal to 1 means output equal to 1. Okay. Then similar to the previous case, you can design the circuit. That means by draw the corner of map, by making the reduction, you can get the output. Then excitation table from the characterization or output or truth table. So Qn and Qn plus is equal to 0, 0 means D input is equal to 0. 0, 1 means 1. 1, 0 means 0. 1, 1 means 1. Okay. Then now I am moving to JK flip-flop. The JK flip-flop. After that, D flip-flop by using SR flip-flop. Now I'm moving to the another one important topic called JK flip-flop. JK flip-flop. We will discuss about the JK flip-flop in the next part. Before to that, so far, topic we have discussed is SR flip-flops, D flip-flop, and one more flip-flop is also there, that is called T flip-flop. What is the difference between the previous one and this one? That means here, instead of using inverter gate, I'm shorting my SR terminals directly. Directly I'm shorting means we called this as a T flip-flop. This is called a T flip-flop. Instead of using an inverter, directly connected here. That is called a T flip-flop. What is meant by T? D means delay, T means toggle flip-flop. T means what? Toggle flip-flop. Toggle means changing. It means that what? Please listen the operation of this. So initially my T input equal to zero. Please listen carefully. T input equal to zero. What will happen? Since there is no inverter or whatever may be here, both are short circuited. So here also zero, here also zero. Okay. Clock input equal to one. So 1 1 1 1. Then one of the input equal to 1, zero, so output equal to 1. Here also one of the input equal to 0, output will be 1. Okay, now initially we made the assumption my Q output equal to initially 0, hence Q bar equal to 1. Please listen carefully. Since it is 0, what will happen? This comes to here. One of the input is equal to what? Now zero, so this makes the output equal to 1. That 1 comes to here, so zero here. Okay, zero here. Now if suppose I assume here as a 1, here as a 0, what will happen? Since here it is 1 1, this 0 comes to here, that makes this output equal to 1. Then that 1 comes to here, all the inputs are 1, then again output will be 0. Then output will be 0. Okay. So this is the first thing. Whatever the initial state we assumed, the same thing only I am obtaining here. But now instead of this, I am going to take my T input equal to 1 now. T input equal to taking as 1 now. What will happen? This 0 now changing to 1. This 0 is also changing to 1 now. What will happen? All the inputs are now 1. So output will be 0 here. Here also output will be 0. What will happen? So this makes the output equal to 1. That 1 comes to here, this is also 1. It is not possible. This is not a possible state. This is not a possible state. So, as I already mentioned, T flip-flop means toggle, but so far there is no toggling the output. So, by using SR flip-flop, there is no chances to design any T flip-flop. That means toggle flip-flop. So, by using SR flip-flop, we can design either a CSR flip-flop or a CSR flip-flop or a SR flip-flop or delay flip-flop only. Toggle flip-flops is having this problem. That means race around condition. This particular call operation is called race around conditions. It can be overwhelmed by T flip-flops. We will see by using JK flip-flop. That can be overcome by using a JK flip-flop. We will see in the next part. We will see that things are in the